Amen, amen. I bless the Lord this morning. I am well. I am born again. My name is Elijah Nyamanga. And I thank God this morning for this opportunity that he has given me and you to be in the house of the Lord today, that we may share together the word of the Lord. I am grateful for this opportunity that I've been given, even to stand here. So thank you very much, our bishop and our mom, and all our pastors and all the men leaders for giving me this opportunity. I want us to share the word of the Lord briefly, and I believe the Lord is going to bless our souls this morning. Amen. So let's go to the book of Luke, chapter 7. Luke chapter 7. We are reading from verse 36 to verse 50. When one of the Pharisees invited Jesus to have dinner with him, he went to the Pharisee's house and reclined at the table. A woman in that town who lived a sinful life learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house, so she came with an alabaster jar of perfume. As she stood behind him at his feet, weeping, she began to wet his feet with her tears. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and poured perfume on them. When the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, "If this man were a prophet, he would know who is touching him and what kind of a woman she is, that she is a sinner." Jesus answered him, "Simon, I have something to tell you." "Tell me, teacher," he said. "Two people owed money to a certain moneylender. One owed him 500 denarii and the other 50. Neither of them had the money to pay him back. So he forgave them the debts of both. Now which of them will love him more?" Simon replied, "I suppose the one who had the bigger debt forgiven." "You have judged correctly," Jesus said. Then he turned toward the woman and said to Simon, "Do you see this woman? I came into your house. You did not give me any water for my feet, but she wet my feet with her tears and wiped them with her hair. You did not give me a kiss, but this woman, from the time I entered, has not stopped kissing my feet. You did not put oil on my head, but she has poured perfume on my feet. Therefore, I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, as her great love has shown. But whoever has been given little, loves little." Then Jesus said to her, "Your sins are forgiven." The other guests began to say among themselves, "Who is this who even forgives sins?" Jesus said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, speak unto us this morning, for your children are here listening. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. This morning, I just want us to share briefly on the word of the Lord. And we have read about a woman who has gone into a house unnoticed. I want to speak about the haven of rest. There is a place of rest for your soul. So, a Pharisee asked Jesus to go and dine with him in his house. And Jesus agreed and went. The Bible records as Jesus was reclining on the table, an intruder came in. A guest came in unnoticed. No one knew that this lady would come into the house. And so the Bible records she came and stood behind Jesus, weeping. And as he was weeping, he poured perfume or an ointment at the feet of Jesus. He was wiping his weeping, and the tears were, he was using the tears to wipe the feet of Jesus. He poured oil, the perfume, at the feet of Jesus. And this did not go well with the owner of the house. The owner of the house, Jesus is introducing him to us as Simon. And Simon, in his heart, he did not speak these words openly. No one heard the words. He spoke to himself. But Jesus Christ heard the word. Jesus Christ knew that which was in the heart of this Pharisee. And so, Simon said in himself, if this were a prophet, if this man were a prophet, he would know the kind of lady that is touching him, that he is a sinner. This man has already passed judgment on this woman, that he is a sinner. It is like this woman was well known in the city. She was well known in the city. And maybe the other day, Simon saw her somewhere, maybe in a bar somewhere. And right now, he's seated, standing behind Jesus, weeping and kissing his feet. It didn't go well with this owner of the house. But Jesus knew what was inside him. And Jesus said unto him, Simon, I have something to tell you. Then Simon said, Teacher, go on, tell me. Then he brought in a parable and said, there are two people who had debts. They could not pay. And so the owner, the one whom they owed, decided to forgive them both. One was forgiven 50, the other one 500 denarii. And so he asked Simon, whom do you think would love him most? Then he said, the one to whom much debt was forgiven. And Jesus said, you have done it. You've said it well. Then he turned to the woman and said to Simon, that Simon, do you see this woman? I came into your house. You did not give me water for my feet. But this woman, give us verse 45. This woman, the Bible says, this woman, since I came in, if you can get verse 45, you did not give me a kiss, but this woman, from the time I entered, has not stopped kissing my feet. Since I entered into your house, this woman has not stopped kissing my feet. Maybe you can pause a bit and ask yourself, between Jesus and this woman, who came into the house first? Who came into the house first? Jesus came into the house first. But here Jesus is saying, since I entered, in other words, even before this lady came in, she was already kissing my feet. Bwana asifiwe sana. Before I came into your house, there is somewhere I had met this lady. The Bible does not record that, but I feel in my heart there is somewhere they had met. The work of grace had started working in the life of this lady. And so it was the power of God's grace that was compelling this lady to come and look for Jesus where he was. She learned, the Bible says, she learned that Jesus was in the Pharisee's house.
And so she came. Now, Simon hakukosea. This lady was a sinner. This lady was a sinner. But she is someone who is tired of her condition. She is someone who is looking for a place of rest. She's looking for rest for her soul. Life has beaten her thoroughly well. She is now tired. And she has realized there is a place. And there is someone who can fix my problem. There is someone whom if I go to, I will get rest for my soul. So the lady decided to come into the house. And she came. And she decided to do something which I believe she had not done to anybody in the whole world. Jesus was so special to him. I don't know what drew this lady, but just as I have said, the saving grace of the Lord had struck the life of this woman. She could not just decide to remain the same. The saving grace of the Lord was pushing her to the place of her destiny, to the place of rest. And so we see her doing something which I believe she had never done to any other man in the whole world. She was weeping and she had a lot of tears. Where can your tears fill the glass? This lady had got tears. Tears that can wash the feet of Jesus Christ. And you know, Jesus was enjoying everything. Bwana sifiwe sana. Because for that, Jesus came. This is a daughter of Abraham who had been tossed to and fro outside there and is looking for rest. And she has come to the right place where her soul can find rest. Jesus was enjoying everything. You know, when Jesus one day was with the Samaritan woman, when he had finished with him, when the disciples came, they were thinking, hey, who has given him food? Jesus said unto them, I have food which no one of you knows about. And my food is to do the work of my Father. Bwana sifiwe sana. And here Jesus is doing the work of the Father. Jesus is doing the work of the Father. He is redeeming back that which was lost. That which the whole village had decided to put away. The one who is well known in the city as a sinner. Even as Simon is telling us here, she is a sinner. He had a bad reputation in the whole town. She was known in every corner of the town. And when people saw her, could point a finger at her and say, do you see that so-and-so's daughter? She's a no-go zone. She's bad. And people could not even associate with her. But her soul, a time came for her soul to find rest. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Even you are here right here today. You know the condition of your heart. You know how much you are longing to have rest. You cannot find rest anywhere except in the Son of God. Bwana sifiwe sana. Now the question is, do you know him? Do you know him who is giving rest to the soul? I don't want us to be like Simon. I don't blame him so much. Because the Bible says he was a Pharisee. And we know how Pharisees used to behave. And most of the time they were at loggerheads with Jesus. Jesus would rebuke them openly because of their traditions and their characters were not conforming to the word of the Lord. And so Simon is just in the house. He is just having fun that Jesus is in the house, but he does not know who Jesus is. That's why he could say in his heart, if this were a prophet, if this man were a prophet. Pharisees, the Bible, Jesus rebuked them one day and said, you praise me with your mouth, you love me with your mouth, but you are very far away, your hearts are very far away. This is what was happening in the house.
The owner of the house has brought Jesus in, but he does not know who Jesus is. He does not know the power that he was in his house, the power to transform his life. He was just there. The master is in my house. The people in the whole town will know. He is in my house. He came and I gave him meat. Jesus does not eat meat. There is food that delights the Lord, and that is doing the work of God. And one of them is the saving of souls, giving our souls rest. That is what Jesus is all about. I'm speaking of a place of rest. You can find this rest in your life. I don't know what you've been going through. I don't know what kind of people have been pointing at you. They have wearied you down because they don't regard you. To you, you are a sinner to them. You are a nobody to them. Your soul is so vexed. You are hard pressed on every side. You don't know what to do. The good news is the saving grace has started to follow you. And the saving grace will lead you to the place of rest. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The saving grace will lead you up to the base of the cross. And from there, Jesus will take over and lead your life and give you a better place in the society. Bwana asifiwe sana. This is Jesus we are preaching. Jesus, the haven of rest. The one who is able to transform lives and make somebody who is a nobody to people, someone so special. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You are a special person in the kingdom of God. It doesn't matter how people see you outside there. As long as you have realized that you have got a problem and there is someone who can fix that problem, all you need to do is begin moving towards the person that is able to fix your problem. This lady had a problem, and the problem was sin. And everybody had got that problem of sin, including Simon. But Simon never realized that he needed Christ. Blessed be the name of the Lord. How is your love for God this morning? Is your love for God like that of Simon, who is just enjoying the company of Jesus Christ, but he does not know the power that Jesus Christ carries? He does not know that Jesus is able to transform a life, that he can be called a child of God, not a Pharisee. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So this morning, this is the word of the Lord for us, that anyone who glories, let him glory that he knows me. Bwana asifiwe sana. That is the word of the Lord. That anyone who is boasting, what do you boast about in life? If there is anything that you can boast about, it is that you know the Lord. This lady knew the Lord. Maybe he had seen Jesus preach in some crusade somewhere. And faith began to develop in her spirit. The Bible says that faith comes by hearing. And what is being heard is the word. So she must have heard Jesus. She must have heard the story of Jesus. The miracle that this Jesus did. She must have heard. And faith began to develop in her spirit. And the saving grace was available for her. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Even right here today, that saving grace of the Lord is available. That grace that can give you rest for your soul, it is available in the house today. If only you will recognize that you have a problem and the problem is just sin, and that Jesus Christ is able to do away with your sin and give you a new garment of forgiveness, that you may walk freely and righteous before the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So it is good for us to know, have that knowledge of Christ in us. Bwana asifiwe sana. What is Paul saying in Timothy? Timothy chapter 2, verse 12. Timothy chapter 1, verse 12. He is saying that I know him whom I have believed in. I know him whom I have believed, And I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have entrusted unto him until that day. Bwana sifiwe sana. I am persuaded. Now it is this persuasion that was drawing this lady to Christ. So she had to break every odd. You know, in this house of Simon, I think she was the only lady. All were men. So it is like ladies were barred from sitting where men were. In our village, we used to have an old mzee, that one who was born 2 years before 1900. She believed that where men are, ladies, they don't talk. Even if they are there, you don't talk. I remember one day, as people were gathering a village meeting, and a certain lady raised her hand and spoke, gave her mind. She got it. All the abuses in the world. And I felt for that lady. It was bad. Some people had got that mentality. But I want to tell you, in Christ Jesus, you are somebody. You are somebody. It doesn't matter how people see you. You are somebody. You are a child of the kingdom. Yes, you are a child of God. You belong there. That is where you will find the haven of rest. Rest for your souls. Bwana sifiwe sana. Let no one intimidate you. Ladies, let no man intimidate you. You are a child of God. You are a child of God. Yes, my fellow man, let no one intimidate you. You are a son in the house of the Lord. And everything that there is for sons in the house of the Lord belongs to you. You are a partaker of it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I know whom I have believed in. And I am persuaded that he is able. I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have entrusted unto him against that day. Is there anything you have entrusted unto the Lord? I have entrusted my life unto him because I know he is able to keep it for me. Bwana sifiwe sana. Hallelujah. So this morning, how is your love for God? How do you relate with him? You know, Jesus knows a casual touch, a casual relationship, from that relationship that comes as a result of faith. He knows how to differentiate them. Let me tell you, Jesus is walking in the crowd. A certain lady comes and touches his garment. Then he's saying, someone has touched me. Bwana sifiwe sana. The disciple was telling, don't you see people are so many here? And you still ask, someone has touched me. The Son of God knows. A casual touch from the touch of faith. Will you increase your faith today? Touch him. He will fill you. Jesus will fill you. Bwana sifiwe sana. In that crowd, there were so many people, but Jesus was seeing only one lady in the crowd. You could be one. We are so many here, but maybe this meeting is convinced for you. You alone. When Christ is looking around, he's only seeing you, that your heart is yearning for him. Your love for him is so great that he cannot bypass you. Bwana sifiwe sana. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And so this morning, there is a place of rest for your soul. Jesus said, come unto me, you who are weary and heavy laden. Bwana sifiwe sana. And I will give you rest. Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, he is the rest we need. He is the rest that we need. May we get in and receive the rest from the Lord. We have been tossed to and fro. We do not know where to turn to. But today, there is a place for rest. There is someone who has guaranteed our rest. And our rest is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Bwana sifiwe sana. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So number one thing I want you to know is ask yourself this question. Do you really know him? Do you really know him? If you know him, then you are in a better position to receive rest for your soul. If you do not know him, if you are just seeing him as just another Galilean around, you will miss it and your life will remain the same. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Simon, together with those who were in the house, they never knew Jesus. Walijua tu, the master is around. Now when Jesus is telling this guy that, Simon, I have something to tell you. Simon said, Master, say it on. Now, when he said Master, do you think that word came from his heart? No, it was from his mouth. That's why Jesus said, you Pharisees, you just love me with your mouths. Let us stop loving God with our mouths. You know our mouths knows how to love God. But if our mouths are not in agreement with our heart, then we are doing nothing. We are going nowhere. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Simon said, Master, say it. And Jesus knew you are a real hypocrite. You are a real hypocrite. Because you don't believe in me, you are still calling me just if this man knew, he would know the kind of lady touching him. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Jesus wants to fix your life. He's the one who is able to fix lives. Bwana sifiwe sana. During his day, his childhood, people knew him as one who is the son of a carpenter. So they were associating Jesus with fixing stools and tables. But right now, Jesus is fixing what? Souls of men. Jesus is fixing our souls. We are tired in one way or another. The only one who is able to fix you is Jesus Christ. Don't call him the carpenter. He's the fixer of souls. Bwana asifiwe sana. And so this morning, he is in the house. He is in the house just to fix you. I don't know how you feel this morning. What are those things that are wearing you down? You can lay them down at the feet of Jesus this morning. Blessed be the name of the Lord. This lady knew Jesus. And she knew that all my problems, I will lay them down at his feet. And that is what she did. She realized, I know. This is the man who can transform my life. This is the man who is able to restore my dignity in the society. This is the man. I can trust him. Yes. And so she came. As a token of appreciation, she came with an alabaster jar of perfume. Amen. She was just appreciating the grace that was working in his life. Begin to appreciate God. Begin to appreciate him for what he is doing in your life. Yes. Begin to appreciate him. Because if it were not for God, you and me, we would have gotten lost outside there. But that grace got hold of you. That grace got hold of me. Why don't we keep on walking in this grace, appreciating God for who he is in our lives? And we shall see things working for us. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We appreciate the Lord this morning. Jesus said, come unto me, you who is weary and heavy laden, then you will find rest for your souls. There is rest. There is rest for us. And that rest is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Hallelujah. Get to know Jesus. Know him well. Know him together with what he can do to you. In Philippians 3, verse 8 to 10, we see Paul is saying, Philippians 3, 8 to 10. What is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage that I may gain Christ. Bwana sifiwe sana. You have to reach a point where you consider nothing now. You consider everything garbage. Yeah? Some versions say rubbish. You cannot compare those things with the excellency of the knowledge of the Son of God. That's why I'm saying you must know your Lord. Know him well with the power that he has that can transform your life. Paul says, I have lost everything just for the sake of Christ, that I may attain him. So I see this woman saying, I want to attain Christ. I have found him who sees me. I have found him who is able to uphold my dignity in the society. I am not getting out of this. I am not getting out of this place. It doesn't matter what these men around are thinking of me. I am here. Because as long as I am in the presence of Jesus, no man will chase me away. Bwana asifiwe sana. As long as I am in the presence of Jesus, he will defend me. Jesus will defend me. Bwana asifiwe sana. I remember one point in the scripture. A certain lady also came with an oil. He broke it and poured it on Christ. And someone said, hey, this is a waste. This is so expensive. This oil could be sold and given to the poor. But Jesus defended this lady. He said to them, leave her alone. Bwana asifiwe sana. Leave her alone. So this morning, I'm just finishing up. And I believe the Lord has spoken or is still speaking into your spirit. Jesus will defend you. Just know who he is in your life. Let us not behave like the Pharisees who love Christ with their mouths, but their hearts very far away. If that is the condition of our heart, then we are doomed. Jesus is saying, you are a real hypocrite. But I thank God this morning because he is in our midst today to fix our lives. It doesn't matter how far we have gone away. As long as the saving grace of the Lord is hitting your life this morning, you are coming back to the right place, the feet of Jesus Christ. That is where you belong. That is where your life will hold together. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Yes, know you are God. Know you are God. Know you are God. Know him well. He is able to transform and change your lives. Hallelujah. So this morning, that is the word of the Lord for us. Do you really know him? You can ask yourself that question. Because if you really know him, then you have got every solution to your life. Every solution to the problem you may be having is right there in front of you. And that is Jesus Christ, the Son of God. He is the haven of rest. Do you want to find rest for your soul? Embrace Christ. Do you want to find rest for your soul? Don't let him go. And don't let any distraction come between you and him. This lady forgot herself. It is like she abandoned herself. And she decided it is only me and him. Yes, I know there are men in that house, but it is only me and him. And I'm going there as an intruder. Because if I go and ask permission, they will not allow me in. Simon will not allow me in his house because he knows I am a sinner. Blessed be the name of the Lord. She came and noticed. She came and noticed. And because the master was in the house, no one would dare talk to him, to her. No one dared question, why are you here? When we are in the presence of the Lord, when we have decided to come and just get hold of Jesus Christ, every other thing disappears. You only find yourself and Jesus. You only find yourself and Jesus. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. May we find ourselves with Jesus always. Let us find ourselves with him. Let's keep on brushing shoulders with him. Then we will be in the right place and in the right position. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, receive all praise. Receive all adoration this morning. We are grateful, Lord, that you've spoken unto our spirits, O God. How we pray that we may know you better, Jehovah Father, together with the power that raised you from the dead. In the name of Jesus, we pray that our relationship with you, O God, is not going to be just a casual one, dear Father, but that which comes as a result of faith. May your saving grace, my Lord, begin to hit every one of us this morning, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May we find soul rest for our souls this day in the mighty name of the Lord. Because Jesus, you are the haven of rest in the name of the Lord. We love you, Jehovah. We exalt your holy name this morning because you are good. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord bless you.